a lot of people basically in the nutrition industry really down ketogenic dieting. You know, they say it's bad for human performance. Dr. Lowery and I were one of the first to actually study the impact of ketogenic dieting on strength, on power, and on muscle mass. So when we formulate products, we're testing all these different combinations and seeing what's optimal. Once we find that optimal combination at ASPI, that's the formula that we use in PRÜVIT. We're also at ASPI, we have all sorts of instruments and techniques to look directly at muscle mass. So we can image like the quadriceps or the biceps, for example, directly from the top of the muscle to the bone. And what we've been doing to prove it is actually seeing that when you diet, you typically lose muscle mass. But when you actually are on ketones, it prevents that from happening.
Our lab was one of the first ones to show that when you eat a well-formulated ketogenic diet and have ketones elevated, you have these muscle sparing effects of ketones, but also this anabolic or muscle building effects of ketones that can happen, where you can gain just as much muscle on a well-formulated ketogenic diet or being in ketosis as you can having a high carbohydrate diet. Ketones act as muscle builders. They actually trigger something known as muscle protein synthesis, very similar to how protein works. So it's really working on both ends of the spectrum to help build muscle and prevent muscle loss. Oftentimes people think that if I drink exogenous ketones, it's going to stop my body's own production of ketones, or what we call endogenous ketones. Well, a recent study from Dr. Jeff Volek showed that people who were on a ketogenic diet and supplementing with exogenous ketones did not have any difference in overall ketone levels or fat loss, which means that the exogenous ketones did not blunt this process known as lipolysis or stop fat loss or stop our body from producing its own ketones, or this concept known as ketogenesis.